It looked like somebody was bent over and had their head in the window of the deer blind. It either heard me or smelt me, and he pulled his head out of the tent and stood straight up, and that shocked me. They don't make people that big.
The way it moved, almost as if it was gliding across the beach. I've never seen anything move like that in my life.
What will you call it?
They were screaming at each other in gibberish. It sounded like a language, and they were chuntering away back and forwards, back and forwards, back and forwards. I know what a bear looks like, and there is no way on this planet that what I saw were bears.
Jesus Christ, you better... Sheriff, Gia!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him. Uh-oh.
This is Susie from Southern California. You are listening to my favorite show, Sasquatch Chronicles.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you. We're going to be chatting with Brian. And Brian comes to us from Colorado. And back over 45 years ago, he had an encounter near Evergreen, Colorado. And he was with a friend of his. And I'm truly honored talking to Brian. This is the first time he's ever really come out and spoke about this encounter publicly. And I know he's nervous, and I'm really happy to have him on tonight. We're also going to be chatting with Camille. And Camille had an encounter in Oklahoma, very recent encounter, actually, about a year ago. She had this encounter with a female Sasquatch. And one thing that's really cool talking with Camille, her husband is from North Africa, and she made a trip to North Africa. And she was telling me about kind of their feelings on the creature and experiences people have there. So I asked her to share a little bit of that with us tonight. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. It's going to be warm in North America this weekend. I hope everyone stays nice and cool. Thank you again for being here. Let's jump into it. I want to welcome Brian to the show. Brian, thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Wes. Thanks for having me today.
Yeah, I'm honored to have you on, Brian. And I know this encounter takes place in 1976 in Colorado. If you would just kind of take us back to that day, what were you doing and what happened?
Well, real quick, how we got to Colorado. I was 17, and my friend was just getting ready to turn 17. He had graduated, and I had left school after about a week in September of my senior year, and I'd been through some things, and I just wanted to get away with him. He had planned to go to Colorado to stay in some friend's cabin that they have out there, outside of Evergreen. It's a paved road to get out there, and then you go turn up and go up the mountain back into the cabin, and there's cabins spread out all through there. The family that owned the cabin, their son lived right down the road from us in his house and had for many years. This was the gentleman's family cabin, the one we stayed in. So we get out there to Evergreen, Colorado. You know, we're young. and amazed at the mountains and just the elk. And we, you know, we grew up in the Midwest and it's cattle and horses and corn. So every day was just a new day and we just enjoyed the hell out of it. And Gary, who was the son of the family, he drove a fuel truck to all these cabins where he would deliver fuel oil back in the day. This is 1976, September of 76. We would ride with him on the back roads and stuff, so we knew what we were doing and getting around. Well, anyway, we got down and he got us a job at a bar restaurant down in Evergreen. We both worked there. I washed dishes and did everything, and so did he. He was a bar back. We thought we were a big deal because we're working in a bar, you know, and that time you could drink three-two beer, what they called it. So anyhow, we get off around 2:30 at night and then have to drive home. My friend owned a 1967 Chevy Impala. So we get off work. This is probably around the middle to the end of September by now. We had been there several weeks. And we're going down the road. It was about 5 miles out of Evergreen. And it's a pretty flat road. It's pretty straight. But on each side, one side, which would be the passenger side, I was looking straight up a 45-degree angle mountain with a ditch and a guardrail. And this is, it was a big mountain. It wasn't a small one. And on the other side, on the driver's side of the car, Daryl was driving, there was a guardrail, probably a 45, maybe a 50 foot angle down to the, there was a stream that went across there. And I say stream, but it was a pretty fast running drainage area. It had rained, so there was quite a bit of water running down through there. And at that that point, it's about maybe 45, 50 yards across that. And then it goes up into another mountain with a lot of, aspen trees. But you could see, it was a pretty clear night. It was, you know, you could see over there. Anyhow, we're just cruising back. We never drove fast on that road because there is wildlife. You know, we had seen elk, lots, tons of elk, and mule deer. So, you know, we were driving maybe 45, 50 miles an hour. We're just chatting back and forth. And all of a sudden, we come up, and I said, Daryl, there's something to the left of us up here by the guardrail. And he says, is that an elk? And I said, I don't think so. It's pretty, it's big. It's huge. He said, it's got to be a bear then. So we slow way down. I mean, way down, maybe 10, 15 miles an hour. And we just start creeping ahead. Well, as we started to creep ahead, it stood up and took one step. And when I say a step, it went from the guardrail to the center line of the road. I opened the door, and he's still creeping ahead. I opened the door to stand up, and I yell at him to stop. And I stand up with the door open, holding on to the door, and I look up. And I mean, look up. It was, I'd never seen anything remotely like it. I'd seen gorillas, bears, the whole gamut, moose. And he's in the car and he says, it's a moose. I said, no, it's not. And at that time, on the Chevys, the lights were low. So where the lights hit it, I would say it would hit it at the lower leg, like in the calf muscle, and a little bit higher. That's